Hello, it's Katie from Let's Talk Marvel Fan Theories. I just wanted to make a quick video talking about something I think has been an ongoing debate since we found out about the new Marvel Disney Plus shows, which is, do you need to watch them? The release of Phase 4 brings not only a slew of new movies, but also various TV shows. Some of these shows, such as What If, will have about no effect on the MCU at all. However, the newest releases, including WandaVision, The Falcon and the Winter Soldier, and Loki, are a different story. Do you need to watch them? Now, the easy answer is no, but the much harder answer is yes. Technically, you would be able to manage to watch the movies and generally understand them without seeing the new shows. However, I'm going to break down a couple of reasons why the shows are still very critical to the future of the MCU. To start, our king himself, Kevin Feige, has come out and said that the shows will be very important for fully understanding the movies. So if you want to get all the details and follow along in depth, the shows are going to be critical. This isn't surprising, since the Disney Plus shows were released with the intention of tying them in with the rest of the MCU. Also, the new shows all include MCU characters, including Wanda, Vision, the Winter Soldier, Falcon, and Loki. Previous Marvel shows have not so blatantly had our beloved MCU characters in them, if, of course, you don't include Agent Coulson. But, as much as I love the man, he's not quite to the same caliber as Wanda or Loki. These are characters we already know and are familiar with. Therefore, their shows need to be seen as something of important offshoots of things we've already seen the characters involved in. Another important thing to remember is that these shows are no different than various movies coming out. By not watching them, you are essentially missing three huge chapters in the MCU. Can I watch Black Panther without having seen Iron Man? Yeah. Can I watch Doctor Strange without seeing pretty much any of the Captain America movies? Also yes. But in the big picture, am I going to miss some things by not having seen these movies? Absolutely. The same goes for these shows. You will be able to generally understand the new movies without the shows, but you will have missed whole segments that include character development, the introduction of new characters, and changing character abilities or powers. Lastly, these shows are meant to set up future events, which comes either in the form of movies or future seasons of the shows, and this alone should be the reason you watch them. Let's take a look at WandaVision, for instance. Now, I will refrain from including any spoilers for those who have not committed to watching it yet, although I'm sure the rest of the internet has not been quite so kind. WandaVision is expected to be a direct lead-up to Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness, and Wanda is expected to be in the movie as well. This being said, the ending of WandaVision is likely going to be the start of the new Doctor Strange, and while they are likely going to doctor it so that those who don't see the shows can still follow along to an extent, the events of WandaVision are going to be critical in understanding Doctor Strange and the Multiverse of Madness fully. There's also been additional word that Loki is going to tie into this movie as well. Essentially, going to see Doctor Strange without knowledge of WandaVision is like bringing your friend who hasn't seen any Marvel movie to see Endgame. You just don't do it. As for The Falcon and the Winter Soldier, there hasn't been much news on where that will fit into the timeline, but you can bet that it will lead into new films itself. And if you're really on the fence still because you don't see the importance of the shows in new movies, look to the past instead of the future. These shows also all help wrap up certain loose ties in Endgame, one of the biggest, if not the biggest, MCU movie to date. WandaVision is based on Wanda's life after Tony's funeral. The Falcon and Winter Soldier follow Sam and Bucky after Cap gave up the mantle and left them to go back into the past. And Loki is set after seeing Loki stealing the Tesseract in the 2012 timeline. Do the characters and Endgame justice and go watch the Disney Plus shows. They're definitely worth the watch, and watching them will be the only way to really stay invested in the future of the MCU. If you choose not to watch these shows, it is the equivalent of not staying for an end credits scene at the end of the films. Everyone is going to be talking about them and what is to come, but you were too busy going to the bathroom and warming up the car, so now you have absolutely no clue what they're talking about. Don't be that guy, because if you have found yourself here, I know you already aren't that guy. Now, I hope you enjoyed this little video about why you should be watching the new Marvel Disney Plus shows. Hopefully, I have changed your mind if you were unsure of their importance in the MCU, and you will be binging WandaVision to catch yourself up. Don't forget to like it and share it with other Marvel friends who might be unsure about watching the Marvel Disney Plus shows as well. Also, to keep the conversation going, make sure to check out the blog that is linked in the description for more Marvel material and theories. Currently, I have been talking a lot about WandaVision, with the newest post including my theories on the season finale and what might happen next. You can find my blog at letstalkmarvelfantheories.wordpress.com. So don't be afraid to go check it out and subscribe to it while you're at it. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to start binging.